Quick start, lights. We need light in our scene. There are already two lights in the scene. A Hemi lamp and a sun lamp. The Hemi lamp has the camera icon off. This means this light does not affect the scene when rendering. The sun lamp here is active. It will light the scene when rendering. Let's unhide it. Click at the eye icon here. And now you can pull the lamp around like any other object. To add more lights, to create a three-point lighting, for example, go to the Create tab. And under the Add Misc, you can find a lamp section where you can add other lamps. Back to our sunlight. Go to the Data tab, and here you can find the settings for our sunlight. You can also change the type of the light. Let's use Spot here. Play around with the settings to get comfortable with. The important bit is use notes. At the moment, you can just adjust the color, not the intensity of this light. When you use notes, then you turn this light here into an emissive material where you can adjust the strength of the light. Let me show you what I mean, but first let's pull down the dimensions a bit so that it doesn't need too long for rendering. F12 to render. And as you can see, the light is pretty dull at the moment. Let's go back to the light and turn the strength to, let's say, 1000. Hit F12 to render again. And you can see the light is much brighter. Let's hit Escape to escape the render result. Now a quick tip, when you search for complete light setups, here you can find the MiniLightLib add-on. Please refer to the manual how to use it. And finally a last hint, we have set up this light for the Cycles renderer. We use here the Cycles render to render this image. The Blender internal renderer will not work with this light. We have now added an emissive material for cycles. So when you want to render with the Blender internal, then you have to use this light without nodes.